coming at you from a very messy Christmas table covered in card making supplies. I had a workshop at the college that I teach beading classes at. This time incorporated some card making in with the jewelry making. I took a lot of my personal supplies to this workshop and I just thought, you know, this is crazy. I've got an entire craft store in my office of scrapbooking supplies, not even just the beading stuff. I did try to sparkle them up with my brand new Wink of Stella glitter pins. Oh my goodness. So exciting, so exciting. I have more colors hidden around somewhere, but oh my gosh, trying to find them on this table is insanity factory. I opened up several of my containers of pens, but not all of them are glittery. Some of them are metallics. I do have some of the other, the Wink of Stella pens kind of mixed in here on top because I'm using them quite often. But the red and green and gold and then the lovely clear is really nice. I like the Wink of Stella pens because it's a glitter pen, but it gives such an ultra fine glitter. Can't see what I'm doing. So you just color the things that you want to accent with the different glitter, and it will give an ultra fine glittery shimmer to whatever it touches. And I just love that. I think it lends a very nice effect, especially if you use any kind of metallic marker first to give kind of the, you know, that metallic sheen. It's not quite glittery, but it's metallic looking. So use that first and then accent it with a matching Wink of Stella pen, or, you know, semi-matching, or not even have to be matching if this is the only one you get. These are fairly expensive, so you can buy them separately, but I got a little set. Another good find, and I've had these for a long time, I've just not actually used them before. These are the metallic Crayola markers, and I believe they came in a set of 9 or 10 colors, but they have kind of a fat tip. And I'll give some examples of the cards that I've made just to show you what I've done, because there's so many possibilities. From a paper pack, and it's a 12 by 12 paper, but as you can see, there are 1, 2, 3, 4 different designs here. They're kind of large, and then there's some little round sentiments here on the bottom. Laugh, warm wishes, hope, just for you, love, peace, and joy. And then there is a Merry Christmas and the December 25th dates. But what is pretty cool about this is that you can cut this apart, and then you can use some cracked scissors with the different little patterns to cut your edges into different little patterns if you'd like, and either mail that in an envelope just alone after you've written a sentiment, maybe on the back, because it does have a snowflake pattern on the back that you can write a message if you'd like. You can either do that, or you can make it a panel and pop it on some cardstock, 5x7 cards. This is craft paper, and then I've also got it in white where it comes with the envelopes as well. This is called the Holly Jolly Collection. I don't know if you got this little paper packet, Michaels. It's by a company called Kaiser Craft. Anyway, I ran out of cards, and then I've not had real time to continue to make individualized from total scratch cards with, you know, using my little blanks here. So that's another way to kind of help me out. I'm still making the card by layering and everything, but I'm not having to do each individual sentiment from scratch, whereas my other cards, I'm having labels, I'm doing Sizzix embossing. I don't know if you can see this. This says Merry Christmas. I did this one on my Sizzix machine. I'll share with you some of my crazy card making. I'm also going to post some of the cards that my students made in the button jewelry class that I just had so that y'all can see what they did. They really enjoyed it and they did such a good job. Thank you. so, as many scrappers know, you have punches, right? And you need that bow tie right there, but you don't necessarily need the mustache. What are you going to do with all the little mustache pieces that you have? I didn't know. I'm like, you know, I brought all these little pieces that I punched out for my students. And I told them, hey, I've got all this stuff. You can make whatever you want. It doesn't have to be a button theme. I've also got stickers, but I do have these mustaches that I have no idea or what you can do with them. There were a couple of guys though in the class, or actually there was four guys in the class. And I told them they're each gonna get a mustache. Well, one of the students used the mustache and some of the little buttons to make a Santa Claus. And I had no clue. I'm like, oh my gosh, what a spectacular use of a surprise piece that I thought was just going to be in my little baggie forever. But this is a nice punch. And if you're just punching out a whole bunch of stuff and you realize, hey, I don't know if I'm going to use the mustaches or not. Well, there's a use for it. For Christmas cards, make a Santa Claus mustache and there you go. Moved on to the card making aspect of this lovely little Christmas button project. I've pulled out some stamps. I got these little cute little Christmas stamps, I don't know, last year or the year before at the Dollar Tree, and I just got to thinking they're like the size of little buttons. So since I've got a button, couple of button hole punches here, I thought maybe I could try that out with the stamp in addition to, you know, some pattern papers and stuff like that. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to do some stamping on some panels. That way people can make whatever they want and color it later if they wish, or, you know, if they have time to color it in the classroom. Got some washi tape and some twine. Just all kinds of little ideas here. A Christmas tree punch and a label punch and some glues and things. So I've got some of the ugly buttons here from my stash in the red and green colors, and I've got ready-made cardstock that's in a 5x7 size already. So I'm going to do one of my demonstration cards here just to kind of give them an idea of what all they can make with the various things that I'm going to punch out. And then I'm going to actually go get my Sizzix machine, because I have these little stamp sets here that might be pretty cute for them to maybe play around with in their cards. I've laid out my buttons here in a wreath shape. I'm going to use this 3-in-1 glue. And then I've also got these glue sticks. These though really are for paper, not for the buttons. So I'm going to use my 3-in-1 glue to glue these where I've got the mat. And I don't want to put a huge amount of this glue on here because I don't want it to soak the card. But I do want it to adhere well. Ugly buttons here so I can get rid of them, but you know, collectively they don't look ugly. So there is a wreath. Okay, so here is a little bow that I made just out of the red and green twine, and I'm going to hit it with a little bit of glue right there, and then I'm going to stamp a sentiment. So I'm going to put the glue on this side of my knot for the lovely twine bow I made. And this 3-in-1 glue does not take long to dry. So there's a cute little wreath with a bow, and it says, "Have a Merry Christmas." That's one little card. So this time I'm going to make a candy cane. So I'm going to change out the buttons. Card example, and I am using my little peppermint buttons, and I'm just using those. You can use any kind of buttons that you want, but I thought it'd look really cute since I'm making a candy cane. And I'm going to glue these down again with the 3-in-1 glue. This one, I used some washi tape that has little peppermints on it to do the border around my card. And I also used a label with some adhesive. These came from the Dollar Tree, and I think there was like 3 to a pack. The adhesive is really strong. So that is card number 2. All right, here is my next Christmas card, and it is just a simple Christmas tree. Again, I'm using some washi tape down there, and I've just kind of cut it as a flag on both sides. I took one of my metallic Sharpie pens in silver. I would rather do that in white, so it looks like white stitching, but this is as good as I could get. I have this Sharpie in silver, and I just went around the edge there, and then I took a metallic gold marker and went around the little star, that little flower button that looks like a star. And then I glued some little tiny buttons on top of the larger green buttons, and I did layers of different types of green in my tree to kind of give it a neat, interesting look. All right, those are the display cards. It's the last of my card making for tonight. There's the candy cane card, the wreath card, Christmas tree card, and now the Christmas ornament card. On this one I put some more washi tape, some glitter tape, and I used the gold to color over the embossed Happy Holidays. So I think they all turned out very cute. I even made mistakes right here on this Happy Holidays card because I'm in a hurry. And after I did some little fixes here and there, I don't think that you can really tell it. Have a sparkle-rific Christmas, y'all. Bye.